Oops. Breakfast. Let's start the day.
Hello, it's Monday. Finally, the sun is out. I hope you're all well. Welcome back to my channel, The French Connection.
Electrician is coming tomorrow, so I have to insulate the back of the filter house. So I'm putting some polystyrene boards. What I have done, and I've done now on the four of them, I've done in four bits. So originally I had this part with a batten in the middle. So what I've done on each side is I've added a batten here and screwed it all along the main post. I have done the same on the outside post all along. And then I've cut to measurement the polystyrene board and put some duct tape all the way around just to protect the edges, because you know what polystyrene becomes like. So what I'm doing then is I'm pushing it. I fitted that one just now. And what I'm doing is I am, because I've cut it to measure, but slightly bigger obviously with the duct tape. So what I'm doing now is I'm pushing it. So in fact it's holding, I think it's called by friction. Funny name in French, it doesn't mean that at all. By friction really means something else. So I'm just pushing it, and so it holds by friction here. I'm gonna do the four of them, and then what I do then is I can screw the OSB board on this button, this button, and this button at the end. So I'll catch you when I've done. The four boards are now done and they go almost all the way down to the floor. So now I'm going to prepare the OSB boards.
So I'm just putting the last board, well, the second board, not the last board, the second board. So again, I've cut it to sizes, and I'm gonna, I've locked one screw in right there on in the middle, and then I'm gonna carry on screwing here, screwing here, screwing here, and there you go.
So the board is now screwed, the second board is now screwed, and what I'm going to do is place a few random nails through the board, which is then going to go through the insulation, because although it's friction fit, as it called again, can somebody tell me in the comments, although it's, as James would say, tight fit, I still want to, in case the wood moves and expand and all that, I still want to put a few nails through the board, which is then going to hold the insulation in place, so the board will never, even the insulation board will never go down. I was going to say something else, but I'm going to be rude, so I'm not going to. Only three or four per board, it's plenty enough. you go, all done.
Hey, so that's it. I've put the boards, I've seen the insulation, the boards, I have now painted them.
Yeah.
And I've also put, I don't know if you can see it because it's all black now, I've put a thicker board here for the, you can see it now, for the electric plugs. So there you go, it's all ready. It's gonna dry overnight. Tomorrow morning, Saturday, Mick, my electrician, is coming, who's also Rachel's cousin, and then he's gonna fit. I've got two double socket. He's gonna add another two, so we'll have 8 sockets here. 6, 5. I'm definitely gonna be using, and then spare if we decide to put light or something like that. So there you go. It's Friday. You know, simple job like putting insulation, putting boards and painting, it's like taking like 3 hours. It's ridiculous. So anyway, as usual, paint everywhere. I don't know how I manage. I just don't know how I manage. Curiously, you think you're looking for food, you just had a little bit. Bye for now. I was really, really struggling to find a 1.5 inch cage or strainer, whatever you call it. So I had to order this, which is normally what I would put in an airbed. That's the only thing I could find. So I have bought this piece separately, which is female thread, and of course. Oh, if I can undo it now with one hand. Sorry about that. Oh, you know what it looks like. It just screws in there. And I'm going to solve and weld that at the end. So no fish can get through. I have stopped the pump as you've just seen. So I wouldn't have any problems. Well, that's that glued. I'm going to let the glue cure now. And this way there is no way that the fish are going to go through. So I have put tiny bit of electrician tape here. Oh, you've got Matilda here wandering about, and she's undone that gutter. That gutter here, I had to put it all the way around. You can see it all the way around because Madam climbs and then goes over. So I had to put a gutter upside down, so when she goes up like that, she can't go over. Here you go. Here, Matilda. Yeah, sorry, go back to that. So I was saying that I had to put that electrician tape here because I felt that this was slightly sharp, this edge here. So there you go, done the job. If anything happened to that cage here, I can unscrew it here and change it. But there you go. So gonna let it cure, and then I'll install it. I have put my plaque. There you go, finally found the place. Really like it here. So I'm gonna, now that I know what it looks like and I really really like it, I'm gonna buy one for here, and and I'm not saying anything else because I'm preparing something. Right, bye for now. Right, so this has cured now for more than 3 hours. I'm gonna install it. I just want to say thank you very much again to everybody who has commented. As you know, originally I wanted to fit the cage from the pump, but I couldn't find a way of doing it because it's just too big and I just couldn't do it. And then that's why I decided to put a hose tail. But as everybody said, it would have acted like a Hoover, and even on a big koi, if they fall asleep, they could have been stuck to it. So this is what I went for. I just want to say again, thank you to everybody who has commented. And this is what it's all about. Being able to learn, being able to share, being able to, you know, share the success and share the failures as well, and or prevent things. So thank you very much again. The electric has been done. So all my plugs are here. I've got the
pump for the pod, the UV for the pod, the pump for the skimmer, the air pump. I will have the UV 25 here. And then it means I've got three spare plugs, which is amazing. I have put the, I don't know what you call that, from the UV from the pod. I've put my two Vary pump controller. I've put a little shelf over there, which I will paint probably in red. So that's the air pump. And I have received the cage for the pipe, you know, for the Tempest. And that's our rabbit. Guess what name her name is? Star. So I've got to clean her now. He's just as rabbit, but you know what kids are like, they lose interest. And Jess has now got a horse, so Rachel's having to be over there, you know, about 3 hours a day, and so the rabbit has gone well down the down the drain, should I say. So there you go. So let's clean her. I'm gonna feed her first, keeps her busy. She's cute. That's a bedding area. Edo! She's quite cute. So I used to breed and show rabbits all over the country. I used to breed and show Rexes. So they are the ones, smaller ones, but with a velvet coat, a bit like a like velvet, really. So I used to do quite well with them. Won quite a few things, especially best of breed, even at big shows, national shows. So yeah, this is just a pet. We used to have two, but the other one has died. She had massive complication. Pretty sure she had a tumor. Right, let's feed her. And this is another thing that I've built. So that's it's massive. Doesn't look it. It's probably on the video, but we decided to build a massive hutch with a runner at the bottom. So I made her the ladder just there. And then she's got a bedding area just here. You've seen the little door. Right, better get on. Dylan darned. Normally she runs on the floor while I'm cleaning her, but it's getting quite late. I've got to make dinner. I've got to take a shower, make dinner before the girls arrive. So there you go, let's feed her, clean her. Hello again. So it's Friday and it's been a busy week at work, so I haven't done much and the weather hasn't helped anyway. It's still not great, as everybody know. We're all probably in the same situation. So what have I done? Painted the little shelf there in red. I've started the insulation at the back. I'm not going to film that because you've seen me doing it, you know, on the very first panels, except that this time it's a little bit easier. I'm doing the inside first, then I'm going on the other side of the pond. I'm putting the insulation, and then I will be able to put the feather boards. Unfortunately, I haven't got the right length, so I can't go that way horizontally, but I'm going to have to go vertically, which is fine. What else have I done? Yes, I have stayed away from the pod. Managed to not clean it for 4 days, but today was a little bit too much, so I cleaned it. And effectively, the water has cleared. I also put some MediClay, which I tend to stay away from because I'm always worried that the clay itself is gonna irritate their gills or whatever, but it has really, really cleared the water, as you can see, despite the reflection here. I've also added some plants, as Marek advised me. So what I've done is I've put some little floating basket. I put some tiny, I've removed all the soil. I've put some little gravels and I have put some pumice on the top just to keep it down. And the koi's haven't touched it. It's been like that for 4 days now. I haven't touched this. So I put one here. I put watercress, water mint, that I don't know what it is. Over there I put the mind your own business, the leftovers that I had, and I put another one over there. Let me go over there. And I've put this one here, so watercress, and I can't remember what that one is. So it's pretty cool because sort of hiding the pipe a little bit, you know, takes your eyes away from the pipe. Yeah, there you go. Don't know if I have filmed that. The plaque, really, really love it. But yeah, no, the water has really, really improved. I've done water tests as usual. Still a little bit murky here, but there's no real movement here of the water. So as soon as I'm finished down there with the electric, I'm gonna, you know, tidy up all these cables now. Now that I've painted that, I need just the space at the moment to finish off the insulation at the back, or on the side, should I say. And then I'm gonna tidy that up probably tomorrow, because tomorrow is gonna be chucking down with rain. So I might as well be in the filter house. And I need to refurbish the multi-bay and install it. But yeah, the water is much, much better. Still tiny bit cloudy, but from here you probably can't see it properly because it's... But anyway, I'm a little bit happier because last week I was really, well, at the end of last week, I was really about it. Done some water tests, and the nitrate, which I had problems with, has finally gone down. Phosphate has gone down a little bit as well. It's gone down to 2 mg/L, I think that's what it is. So not at its highest like it was. So yeah, we're quite happy with that. It's finally getting there. What I have done as well is I have moved or repositioned a lot of the Chiguire backy house media that I had, because here I had a little bit of a area where it was really clogged up, not clogged up, but the flow wasn't the same everywhere. So I repositioned there. Here I've repositioned there as well. I had some pumice from leftover, which I've always liked in my shower. When I had the DIY shower, I used to have that. So I only had like probably like 4 handfuls, so I thought I'd use it. And on the top here inside, I put some floss, which I'm very, very surprised, but it has caught hell of a lot. Yeah, I'm very surprised. But anyway, that's the update for now. And Jeff, I still haven't painted the roof, or the inside of the roof, sorry. I'm gonna do it. I've been really, really lazy this week. But there you go. So pretty pleased with the progress, sort of. You know, I can't only just concentrate on the koi, unfortunately. I've got so many other animals, I've got to look after them as well. But yeah, progress is always better. Progress is always something. So there you go. Have a nice weekend, everybody, and I will catch you on the next one if you're still watching my videos. Have a nice weekend, stay safe, and be kind to each other. Bye for now.